we go. There's a particularly nice one, that one.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. That's good. Oh, that's going to be... Oh, that's huge.
That's nice. She'll look lovely.
Yeah, that's going to be great.
In your apartment, isn't it?
Okay. Yeah. Well, thanks for that. That's so 70, like we agreed?
Yep, no worries.
That's awesome. Oh, mate, I'm going to put these in my bedroom.
Yeah, no, she's going to look absolutely gorgeous over there. I mean, imagine lying back in bed and having her looking down at you.
Oh, sorry. No, just to clarify, I've got some big photos of myself at home that I'm going to... I'm just using the frame.
Oh, you just want the frame?
Just the frame, yeah. You can have the photo of the... I don't even know who that is.
Don't worry.
Nah, this is real good. That's good quality. Hello and welcome to Neighbourshood. The lovely Stefan Dennis.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much for joining us. You were in the very first episode of Neighbourshood.
Yes, I was. I was here on day one.
Yeah, where it all began. So this week, you almost got married again.
Yeah, again,
to
yeah.
Courtney.
Yeah.
She would have become your...
She would have become a sixth wife.
Sixth wife.
Sixth Mrs. Robinson.
You guys seem to really build a little connection.
Yeah, no, we did, because they started off and it was a business arrangement.
Mm.
If you've been watching the online Mrs. Robinson series, you'll know exactly what I'm talking about.
If you don't know what he's talking about, go and check it out on all the social media channels and YouTube and such.
Yeah, we started off with a business relationship. It's kind of warmed and they grew together and all of that, to the point where Courtney actually, later on in it, actually put it on Paul. And he was like, I mean, mad, what a madman, because Courtney,
anywhere, she's way anywhere. Above your weight grade.
No.
So this week, one of your children, you've got three children on the show, was propositioned with another person to go back to someone's house. Do you even know which of those children it was?
Well, you kind of said she, so I'm taking
it. Did I say she? Oh, no! Oh, no! Well, you would have had to rule out David. Obviously, he's with Aaron, very committed relationship.
Yeah.
Mishti and Leo.
Leo.
Very committed. So it was Amy.
Yeah.
How's that, though? How's the cheek of that guy? But you raised a strong, independent woman.
She's a good, good girl.
And she put him in his place. So good on you, Amy.
Yeah.
How do you feel about your son dating a cop? Mishti, obviously, becoming a cop this week. How are you going to murder and kill and,
I know,
and
you know,
steal
it's
anymore?
My old ways, my current ways, my future ways.
Now, you spent a lot of time in the UK these days and in the past when you lived there.
Mm.
Do the fans just go crazy over there?
It depends. If in London, where I lived for a long time, they used to... they
stop you on the street every moment?
Pretty much, but then because I was living there, they got to see me more and more on the street. And people go, oh, this poor Robinson. I mean, people would do it all the time, whisper. Gail, my wife, my real wife, she used to always, we'd walk past and she'd go, oh, they're talking about you. And I'm like,
Well, we snuck onto set this week and got you guys some spoilers. Let's see what we've got. I hear you're the person to speak to about some Neighbours spoilers.
You heard correctly.
Yeah. So I heard a little bit about someone breaking up. Who's breaking up?
No one.
I just gave you money, you have to give me something. Someone just broke up though, right? That's what the whole scene's about?
No, your birdie's gotten something wrong.
That's our cue.
Oh, that's your cue.
But surely, but you and Tyler are back together, but you guys aren't gonna. I mean, you guys are forever, right?
We're a forever couple, maybe. I mean, we've seen some cracks in the relationship, you know, they could get deeper or they could repair. I mean, that's what cracks do. They either get worse or they get better. Does that answer your question? It's a
ballet. Oh, and welcome to the low budget with available props blindfold game. Impossible edition. We've never had an impossible edition before.
We're in Teresa's office at the moment, aren't we?
Yeah, that's correct.
Yeah. Is this couch green?
No, it's brown.
Ooh, okay, good.
Do you know what the blindfold game is?
Yeah, I'm wearing a blindfold.
Yep, and you're going to have to guess about some props that I have in this bag right here.
Okay.
Now, every prop corresponds to one of your lovely wives that you've had on the show. It's going to be very, very hard, okay? All right, here we go. So the very, very first one is here. There you go. Okay. What object is that?
A gun.
It's a gun.
Terry.
Terry, yes.
She shot me.
Yeah, his first wife shot him.
Yeah, nobody remembers that.
Okay.
I do. Still got the bullet wound here.
This is a super hard one, okay?
Okay.
So here, there you go. Yep. Now, can you guess what it is?
It's a card of some sort.
Well, it's kind of a card. It's a sign.
Oh.
This is the most impossible one. So I wanted to do it early so you didn't just like cancel out all the other ones and know exactly which one it was. It's a sign that has a word on it. Yeah, I mean, it's impossible.
Is it an exit sign?
No. Almost, close.
Entry sign?
Yes, if you were gonna go into a door, you would...
Toilet door?
You would push it.
Oh, so there's a push sign.
It's a push sign.
Ah, oh, I know, I dropped it. So much like what she did to me, really.
Yes, who?
Yeah. Jane Hall, Rebecca.
Rebecca, she pushed you off the balcony.
Oh, scissors.
Scissors.
Scissors, hang on, I've got to remember my wife. We've done Terry, we've done Rebecca. So that leaves Gail and Christina and Lim. Oh, Lynn.
Lynn was a hairdresser, correct.
Ah, see.
There you go.
Now, these are three things. Have a little look. Can you guess what they are? They're all exactly the same.
Jelly babies.
Jelly babies. And there's three of them.
That'll be the triplets with Gail.
Gail, yay, jelly babies. Yay. Do you want to eat one?
No, I can't. I've got a blindfold on. I don't trust you.
Well, I just ate one. You can hear me eating them. Here we go.
Yeah, but you might have eaten one out of the bag.
Here we go. Uh-oh. Oh.
There's only two left, so it's a can of something.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh, I didn't want to get it all over me.
If you've tried it, you should know where this is from.
It's creaming soda.
Close.
Well, it's got to be Christina then.
Yeah. Do you know why? Scottish. Her son was Scottish.
Well,
and you're drinking
wasn't. He was
a can of Scottish drink.
Iron Brew.
Iron Brew. Last one. It's Courtney. The almost wife-to-be. All right, guys, let's see who this week's cake taker is. Where do you think you're going?
Home.
No, Rebecca Elmer Loglu, you are this week's cake taker.
Oh, jeez.
What do you think of that?
Great. See ya.
No, wait. You gotta find out why you're this week's cake taker.
What?
At Neighbours tweets. Please, no! Therese and Paul belong together.
Aww.
At Priestley 23. Therese leaving Piper right now to bugger off with Gary is ludicrous, to be honest.
Oh,
what do you think? Alan Fletcher, do you think she's a big cake taker?
Just broke my heart. The whole thing just broke my heart.
Okay.
Oh, he can't.
You
he's
are
on
a cake taker.
He's on a diet. He shouldn't really be eating. Coming up to Christmas. And... Hey, do you wanna come in and have a chat? And...
No, I'm going home.
We could share the cake though.
Bye. Thanks for the cake.
You better eat her cake.
It's a file of facts. We're in Teresa's office. Who on earth still has a file of facts?
Why has she got a big, huge TV screen in her office?
And more importantly, it's a boring movie.
Yeah. We like to go around the crew these days and meet who are the special people out on location and in studio that make Neighbours in a little section we like to call, What Do You Do?
So what do you do now?
What do you mean?
Well, I mean,
or like as a
show anymore,
as a job.
Yeah, what do you do for a gig?
This is what I do.
What do you mean this?
The show, Neighbourshood.
Yeah, it's not a real job.
What do you do here?
I just stand here and hold stands.
Stands?
Yeah.
You're a stands guy?
Yeah, I'm a standing up guy.
Cool. What kind of stand? What goes on the stands?
There's a square thing with chuck on it.
It's a chuck on it? What's that?
We just chuck
Explain
on,
for people who don't know.
It makes people pretty who aren't that pretty.
Name one actor that this helps the most.
I'm not doing
Name
that.
One actor that this helps the most. We all know who it is. Alan Fletcher.
The old bait and hook.
So it came out during the week that Therese and Gary are getting back together. How are you feeling?
I feel okay about it. Paul, on the other hand, he's pretending he doesn't care. Yeah, right.
Could Therese be Paul's potential sixth wife someday in the future?
It's been on the cards for so long.
I'm not sure if he deserves it.
Hang on. What do you mean the other way around?
Therese is a wonderful woman. She's a businesswoman. She's like killing it at life. You put her brother in jail.
He tried to kill me.
Hamish went out with a bang a couple weeks ago. Doesn't look like you're too much
literally.
In the firing line.
Well, no, it wasn't a bang, was it?
At
well,
the
it
moment.
Was a bang.
Some people are saying, potentially, because we don't know who killed Hamish yet, some people think that Yashvi's fireworks could have gone off over the fence, knocked him in the head, and then he fell into the pool. Maybe she's responsible.
That's a twist.
Mm.
I like that storyline.
Well, a few of your neighbours on the street think that they know who killed Hamish. Mm. And here are their reasons why.
Carl killed Hamish just because he passes him off as some kind of medical emergencies. But really, he's a serial killer.
Hamish was really rude one day and he ripped out one of his plants. Like, what are they called? The durian thing? Plants? He stole his durian or something like that. It would have been competition for Carl.
Carl would do it just to get noticed.
Hamish was starting to crack on to Susan. Carl wasn't having a bar of that.
Maybe Susan was like, well, Carl's cheated on me in the past, now it's my turn. And then Carl was like, I'm gonna get in there before Susan cheats on me and kills Hamish.
She'll never know it was us.
Therese, take that! Oh, hello, how are you going? Hey guys, thanks so much for joining us this week on Neighbourshood. We've got lots of big spoilers next week. Tell the viewers just what's happening.
Well, Mark and Aaron skipped town.
Yep.
I don't know why.
They skipped town because something happens with Mark at the police station.
That's good. Stephanie's wellness. Wellness centre. So you haven't got centre.
I didn't write centre.
Ah, no. It might be over before it begins.
Yeah, it might be over.
Oh, Piper.
Schoolies.
Yeah, she's going to schoolies.
But then she doesn't go.
And then she doesn't. She
don't
had
tell
panic
them why.
Attacks instead.
Sonia and Toadie
are
going to
try and have another baby. They're going to have a little baby.
Thanks, guys. See you next week.
Bye.
Yeah, my cards.
Hey guys, thank you so much for watching the video. Hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button. And while you're here, you may as well check out some other content that we have up on the channel. All right, bye. Ow. You may as well click on it now.